How do we find all the factors of 24? It's simple. We write the number as a product of two positive numbers. We have to think of all possible combinations though. How do we write it as a product of two numbers? Let me give you an example. It can be written as 1 multiplied by 24. We have written 24 as a product of two numbers. But remember, we have to think of all possible combinations. It can also be written as 2 times 12. Wait, it can also be written as 3 times 8. Are there any more combinations? Yes, it can be written as 4 times 6. That's it. There is no other product of two positive numbers that would result in 24. Wait, how do we know that all products have been covered? Okay, so always use this logic when you are writing a number as a product of two numbers. Start off with 1. Every number is obviously divisible by 1. Write that product first. Then see if the number is divisible by 2, which is the next natural number. If yes, we write the product as we have written it here. Then we move on to the next natural number, 3. Is 24 divisible by 3? Yes, so we write the product here. Then 4. 24 is divisible by 4 and we wrote that product here. And after 4, we have 5. Is 24 divisible by 5? No, it isn't. So we cannot write it as a product of 5 and another number. And the next number is 6. But 6 onwards is already covered here. That's when we know that we have covered all possible products of two numbers. The numbers covered are in a U shape. Anyway, that's all we had to do. What are the factors of 24 then? All these numbers individually are the factors of 24. We can say that the factors of 24 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, and 24. We write the number as all possible products of two numbers, and then each of the numbers become a factor of that number. Let's try finding the factors of another number. We need to find all the factors of 30. To do that, all we have to do is write 30 as all possible products of two numbers. I will be telling you the answer in some time. Meanwhile, you can try writing down the combinations in your notebook. We can start off with the number 1. 30 can be written as 1 multiplied by 30. This is the simplest and the most obvious combination. 1 is always a factor of all numbers. Then we move on to 2. Is 30 divisible by 2? Yes, and the product can be written as 2 multiplied by 15. Is 30 divisible by 3? Yes, the product can be written as 3 multiplied by 10. Is 30 divisible by 4? No, it isn't, so we cannot write a product with 4 as one of the numbers. What about 5? Yes, 30 is divisible by 5. And the product can be written as 5 multiplied by 6. The next number is 6, which is already covered here. And the numbers after 6 are covered here. That's when we know that we have exhausted all possibilities. These are the only four ways in which we can write 30 as a product of two numbers. So we can say that these 8 numbers individually are the factors of 30. The factors are 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15, and 30. How can we define factors then? Well, the factors of a number are basically exact divisors of that number.